and welcome to Raw Math. Today we're talking about factoring trinomials specifically. All right, so here we have a trinomial, 6x squared minus 11x plus 4. Pause the video if you want to try it on your own and double check to make sure you have the right answer. I'm not going to start this example off with guess and check because of the 6 and the 4. They're both composite numbers, and I would have to do a lot of guess and check to get there. I don't think that that's going to be my best method. So I'm going to start off with AC. AC is named because you multiply your A coefficient times your C coefficient. 6 times 4 is 24. And then you look at your B, which is negative 11. And at this point, you do the exact same thing you would do if A were equal to 1. Find two numbers that multiply to AC and add up to B. So my factor pairs of 24, I start with 1 and 24. Because 11 is negative, I know my big factor has to be negative because my big factor has to match the sign of my B term. Because 24 is positive, I know they both have to be negative because this tells us we're getting there through addition and that tells us we're adding two negative terms together. This is negative 25, that's wrong. If I do negative 2 and negative 12, I would have 14. If I try negative 3 and negative 8, I have negative 11. If this were prime, this is where I would have found it. If none of my factor pairs work, then I know I'm looking at a prime polynomial. If one of these factor pairs work, the whole trinomial is factorable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace 11x with the two factors that got us there. What we're doing is we're doing the inverse of multiplying binomials, and when you multiply binomials, your last step is to combine like terms, which means you might add two middle terms together. So we're going to take this three-term polynomial, find the two terms that were added to get to that middle term, write a four-term polynomial, and then factor by grouping. So we write 6x squared minus 3x minus 8x plus 4 and factor by grouping. Out of my first two terms, I'm going to pull a 3x. Out of the second, make sure you bring this sign down, otherwise things will go awry. I'm going to pull out a negative 4. If I pull out a 3x, I'm left with 2x minus 1. If I pull out a negative 4, I'm left with this negative divided by a negative. That's 2x minus 4 divided by 4 is 1. Because what is inside the parentheses are the same, I'm going to write what's in the parentheses, and I'm going to write what's out of the parentheses. Like I've been doing in my videos, I'm also going to show you my funky RAR way of doing this. Don't try to do each of these problems in multiple methods. Choose the method you like and practice it. Always use the same method. If you switch your methods around, you're not going to perfect any of them. You want to make sure that you can always factor a trinomial. And if you're going to use my funky RAR method and you're doing it for a math class, make sure you preview it with your teacher. Explain to them what you're doing. Otherwise, they're going to have no idea. So my funky RAR method, what we're going to do is we're going to write x minus, let's see, a is 6, 3 over 6, x minus 8 over 6. They're both reducible, so x minus 1 half times x minus 4 thirds. And then I bring my denominators over, 2x minus 1 and 3x minus 4. Same answer, but you have to deal with fractions. Double check, 2x, 3x, that would be 6x squared. So I didn't lose a greatest common factor by using the fractions. Thank you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you've learned something new or got to practice something old. Please like this page. Please share it with friends. Let other people know if you like these videos that this is a great place to get math videos. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.